Hello everyone, welcome to QAFox.com. This is Arun Moturi. In this Selenium automation tutorial series, I'm going to explain the HTML basics for learning Selenium. So HTML basics are one of the prerequisites which are required before learning Selenium, guys. In Selenium, there may be few topics where we need to have some basic knowledge on HTML, then only we'll understand those topics, otherwise we won't. That's the reason I have created a series of HTML basic videos which are required for understanding those Selenium concepts which involve this HTML basics. And guys, one more note here, you don't have to learn the complete HTML, guys. Whatever the HTML basics that I have covered in this video series will be enough, okay? So blindly follow this video series and the HTML basics that are explained in this video series. That will be enough, guys. You don't have to learn more than this. So guys, so far I have explained 11 parts of HTML basics as part of this video tutorial series. In this current session, I am going to explain the 12th part of HTML basics series, that is adding tables to the HTML web page. How to add tables to the HTML web page as part of this 12th part of HTML basics topic. Fine, let's get started with this session. So I will practically demonstrate adding the HTML table to the HTML web pages. Let's say I want to add this table that you are seeing on the screen. Okay, the table that you are seeing on the screen, it's very simple, though I am going to practically demonstrate adding such kind of table on the HTML web page using the HTML code. So if you can see this table, it has two columns, guys. One column name is ID. First column name is ID and second column name is name. Okay. So under the column name IDs, we have the IDs of this table, right? And for each and every ID, there is an associated name, okay, which is related to this ID. So 001 Arun, 002 Varun, 003 Tarun. Like this, three names are there, three IDs are there. Each and every name has its own ID, right? So here columns are ID column and name column, and at same time we have rows, guys. Okay, the first row is this one, second row, third row. Okay, this is heading row, this is heading, this is the row 1, row 2, row 3. So this is the data and these are the headings. Okay, you can differentiate the data from the headings here, right? So ID and name is the heading, whereas 001 Varun Arun, 002 003 Tarun is the data, table data and table headings. Like this, you can differentiate different things in the table, right? Columns, rows, table headings, table data, all such kind of things. This is very simple table, guys. We don't have many columns here, right? And even we don't have many rows also here. Okay, something like around 4 rows and 2 columns are there, and in that first row is nothing but the heading row, whereas the remaining things are the data rows. Okay, let's create such kind of table in HTML. In a practical way, I'm going to demonstrate the same to you right now. Open Notepad++. It's kind of blank here. So before writing any HTML code here, save this file as HTML. Save as desktop tables.html. Extension is .html, guys. And save as type should be all types. Then save it. The file has been saved now properly. HTML file got saved. And it doesn't have any code so far. So let's start writing the HTML code in this. So HTML start tag and HTML end tag. And in between this HTML start and end tags, I'm going to write, create two types of tags, that is head and body tags. Slash head and here body and slash body. Okay. And I would like to as table will be displayed in the body section, okay? Whatever the table that we are going to create, that will be displayed in the body section itself, right, on the page. That's the reason I am going to add the table tags, table code, table HTML code inside this body tags, okay? So for creating a table in HTML, the tag name should be table. And this particular table is the starting tag of this table, whereas it should also end with the slash table, okay? Starting table tag, ending table tag. Inside this table tags, we need to create multiple rows. So if you can see that example, there are 4 rows, right? 2 columns and 4 rows. So what I will do here is I will write four tr slash. Okay, this is the first row. Tr means table row. T for table, R for row. So like that, this thing I will repeat for four times because I want to create four rows in the table. Fine. Then now we have four rows, and inside each row, how many columns should be there? Two columns should be there. So inside every row, I'll create two columns. So for that, I will say td. Okay, td slash td. I'll repeat this two times because every row has two columns. So four rows, and inside each row, two columns. So copy this and paste it in the remaining rows like this. So every row will have the two columns only. Okay, this first column data, second column data. This first column data, second column data. Now, okay, alignment. I am just taking care of the alignment, guys. You also take care of that. So here, okay. So we have, now we have first row, second row, third row, and fourth row. And inside each and every row, there are two columns. First column, second column. First column, second column. First column, second column, first column, first column, second column. Okay, so here the first row, okay, the first table row, the first column value should be the name of the column, that is ID, and the second column value should be the name of the second column. Fine. After that, under this ID, the first row, that is table data, as part of the table data, for this ID, I will write 001. And the associated name I want to be, and the associated name I want to be is Arun. And here, table data again is 002. The associated name I want to be Varun. Then the last row, the ID value I want to write is display is 003, and the name should be, let's say, Tarun. Okay, like this. Now this is fine, guys. We have a table now, and inside that there are four table rows, and each and every table row has two columns. Okay, two columns, and the first column values are the names, table headings. Okay, table headings I am just believing, and the remaining things are the table datas. Okay, table heading values and table data values are there. So this is how we can create a table and save it. Okay, save it. Now go to your desktop, open this. So right click on this tables HTML file, open with the Google Chrome. See what will happen, guys. Okay, whatever you are expecting didn't happen, guys. Okay, maybe the values have come in the proper direction, but you are not seeing any table. Table will not look like this, right? The table will have a border here. Okay, there is no border here. Only data, table headings and data got displayed here, but you are not able to see in a tabular format. Okay. Though they look like, the structure looks like a table, but still it's not a real table for you guys. The reason behind this is every table will have a border, guys. Okay, every table will have a border. Let's draw the border for that. So inside this table, starting tag, create an attribute name known as border and assign it with the value, in the double quotes, give one. Okay, the border size is one. So till now the border was not displayed. After providing the border and saving this file, now when you refresh this page, you see now the table got displayed properly, right? It got displayed. So this is the first column, this is the second column. ID is the first, ID column is the first column, guys. Name column is the second column, and this is the first row, second row, third row, fourth row. But one problem is there here, guys. As you can see here, the data, table data and table headings are displayed in the same font. That means I want these headings to be in a different format, guys. Okay, I don't want them to be in a data format. Rather, some differentiation should be there, right? So that I can understand that all the values displayed in under this are the IDs, and all the values displayed under this name column are the names. So to differentiate that, okay, what we have to do is, we have given TD here. The first row we have given TD. TD means table data. Here also TD is there. TD is there. TD is there. So everything we have mentioned, it is the table data, guys. So to differentiate that, we have to change this TD to TH. TH means table heading. Okay, TD means table data, TH means table headings. Okay, only this particular row, only the columns in this particular first row will be given this TH guys. Remaining will be TD only, table data only. These are our table headings. Okay, save it. Now refresh the page. You see, now we can see that the table headings are displayed differently and table data is displayed differently, and also the tabular format is displayed. And in case you want to increase the border size, okay, if I change it to 2, you can see the difference here. The border will be more thicker. Okay, similarly, let's say 5, save it, refresh the page. You see, it will become more thicker and thicker when you increase the border size from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever you want to give, you can give. So this is how you can create the tables in HTML pages using the HTML code. So here concludes this current session guys. In the next session I will continue with the Selenium tutorial video series. So thank you guys, see you in the next session. Bye.